Happy day, humans. Brewing a proper cup of tea. You know when you've had one. It stimulates and refreshes and smells like heaven. If you've had the dirty water gross kind, spend some time with me, friend. Let me show you the way. Also, vote! First, water. Filtered water is the way to go. Let me put it this way. You want a blank canvas. If your water already has something going on in there, gonna affect the taste of the tea. In order to really get the flavor of the tea, you want the best water. I use a filtered pitcher at home, and at work, I have one of these. In fact, this one gets double filtered. I get water out of the drinking fountain, which is filtered, and then it gets filtered again in this. Super fresh. Much as water is your first step in making tea, registering is the first step to ensure you can vote. Make sure you are registered where you live now. If you aren't sure, you can go to vote.org to find out more information. Next, your kettle. I highly suggest a metal or glass electric teapot. No plastic. I'm super fancy and I have a temperature-specific kettle. This is particularly helpful with green or white tea as they are best steeped at a temperature below boiling. Most of the time I set my kettle to 200 degrees, even for black tea because that's just my preference. Making smart choices about water temperature is similar to thinking about how you want to vote. Do you want to vote by mail? Do you want to vote in person but early to avoid the lines? Do you want to vote in person on the day? What time of day will you go to the polls? Do you know where your polling place is? No matter what you decide, it's important to make a decision and know how you're going to execute your plan. If you're voting by mail, make sure you request your ballot in advance. Also, know when you should receive it by. If you're voting in person, know what you should bring and where your polling place is. Now, while your tea boils, we get out your tea. The world of tea is varied. Black, green, yellow, white, Earl Grey, oolong, pura, chai, rooibos, chamomile, and tisanes of all varieties. Tisane is a variety of tea that contains no actual tea leaves, just ingredients that are brewed like tea. Each of these categories contain multitudes. Smells for days, my friends. The theory is if you like the smell, you will like the tea. I love things that smell of baking. Coconut, vanilla, cinnamon, nutmeg, cocoa. Cloves, some fruits, apple, lemon, orange, and blueberries, and nuts, almonds, chestnut, hazelnut, kola nuts. I do like a good green tea combined with jasmine or roses on occasion, but florals are not usually my jam. Or cup of tea. Selecting your favorite candidate can be just as picky as selecting your favorite tea. Some races and issues show up on the ballot and can be really tricky to understand. This year, I voted by mail and did so while drinking my favorite rooibos. Because of that, I could also research the candidates and issues while I was making my choices. I gathered information from lots of sources, but I found vote411.org to be really helpful, especially on the down ballot races. Down ballot races make a huge difference in the community. You will also need a steeping agent or infuser. This is how you put the tea in the water to get the flavor. There are lots of ones out there that look super cute and adorable. I tend to use simple stainless steel tea infusers, like this one. They have an easy rim to let it sit in the water while also making retrieval easy. How much tea goes in the steeper? Not much. 1 to 2 teaspoons will work for most teas, while occasionally upping it to 2 to 3 teaspoons if the tea is particularly fluffy, like chamomile. It's so fluffy! I've opted out of teaspoons altogether and have switched to this, the perfect scoop. And it is. Plus, it's just ready to use in my tea supplies. You're starting to get the idea of how much tea I drink. So you've got your water ready, you've got your steeper with your properly scooped amount of tea. It's time to pour in the water and set a timer. This is it, folks. This is a really important step. Different teas steep for various amounts of time. Black tea is 3 to 5 minutes. Green and white teas are like 1 to 3 minutes. And many tisanes steep for longer, somewhere between 5 and 7 minutes. The best thing to do is to look at the packaging. The tea vendor will not only give you a recommended steep time, but also a good water temperature. If they don't, you don't want that tea. It can be easy to think that it doesn't matter what kind of water or what kind of tea or how long you steep it for, but it does. It dramatically changes the experience of tea drinking. Similarly, you might think, my vote doesn't matter. I'm just one person. How can my vote change things? The reality is, a lot, particularly in local elections. Many races are decided by just a few votes. And those local elections are much more related to your daily lives than the national ones. Those ideas in local elections, they get passed on and voted on in other communities. And sometimes they get voted on in larger areas, like a county, or a state, or a nation. So voting rights, civil rights, and smoking inside of restaurants evolved. First, it happens in some places, then it goes elsewhere. Local elections matter. You matter. Your vote matters. And if voter turnout increases, whole elections are affected. Never believe that your voice doesn't matter. All evidence to the contrary. So the timer goes off and you can now enjoy your tea. You might want to add some milk or sugar. To each their own flavor. Full fat milk is usually best and does best with most black teas. Some other varieties of tea aren't as great because the milk will curdle. Sugar or honey is usually good with almost any cuppa. I like to balance it with the food I might be having. If the food is already sweet, probably don't need the extra sugar. So that's it. That's all it takes to brew tea. And today, we also spilled the tea about voting. So vote! But for now, a haiku. 'Tis the season to register, vote, and also brew a cup of tea. I have several tea vendors that I love. I will share that information in the doobly-doo. Also, vote!